Ganesh Senior, July 1994. Get ready. Start. Mr. Chairman, sir, I agree with the previous speaker that we are under a handicap. We can speak only on one occasion. On the other hand, there are two occasions for the other house to discuss the budget. Anyhow, I shall try to be short in my speech. In the first place, I wish to point out that it is the duty of the members not only to criticize but also to praise the government where praise is due. Let me start by saying that the government deserves our congratulations since there is no taxation proposal in this year's budget. I have seen three budgets. I consider that this budget is one which makes a special statement of the sufferings of the people. In the budget, we see that statement that we have passed through many difficult periods during the last 7 years. There is another confession that there is a rise in prices. I congratulate the finance minister on making this frank statement. He says that there are two main problems facing the country's economy today. They are the rising trend in prices and the shortage of foreign exchange. When I spoke on the governor's address, I said that the government should take steps to bring down the prices. There is no use of saying that we cannot do it or that there are special factors to be considered. So long as the prices are not brought down, the sufferings of the people will become greater and greater. The next thing that I want to refer to is the seasonal conditions. The finance minister has admitted that in most places there was less rainfall. As a result, it is said that production will go down. There is no doubt about this. Not only the rains have not been adequate, but in some places the crops have been affected by pest. So the production will go down very much. We cannot expect the production at the end of this year to be the same as it was in the previous year. The government may say that the number of acres brought under cultivation has gone up, but in spite of that, on the whole, production has gone down. I wish to point out this thing to the government. Then, in the case of agricultural land, the income will not be the same year after year. So far as the cooperative farming is concerned, we find that it will be a success only if seasonal conditions are favorable. If they are not good, it will be a failure. I would like to point out to the government that agricultural development cannot be the same in all the areas. Where there are industries, we find that there is depletion of agricultural labor. As a matter of fact, if there is a heavy industry in a place, we find that in the surrounding villages, the cultivable land are neglected. I am prepared to show the basis where such things are taking place today. So, I request the government to see that good fertile lands are not neglected. The point I wish to make is that sufficient attention is not paid to land now. The next point that I would like to deal with is the supply of agricultural implements. We find that they are very costly, but we can do one thing in regard to this matter. I would like to suggest that There must be cooperative societies, and through these societies, government may hire out these implements at cheap rates. Then only the lands that are not now cultivated can be cultivated. Letter from Ratna Stores, Madras to Messrs. John and Company, Madras. Dear Sirs, we are very glad to inform you that we have completed 10 years of useful service to our customers. You will be pleased to know that we shall be celebrating our 20th anniversary on the 30th of this month. On this occasion, we have great pleasure to invite you and the members of your staff and seek your continued support. As you know, an important festival comes off towards the end of the month. In order to meet the needs of the occasion, we have received new stock of textiles from leading mills. We are sure that you will be pleased with them and that you will be able to make your selection with great satisfaction. Already, a large number of people have started making purchases and we are very much happy about it. In order to suit the convenience of our customers, we have decided that our showroom should be kept open on Sundays also. In addition to this, we will be giving free gifts on every purchase. As you are one of our valued customers, we are inclined to consider it our duty to inform you of this. We look forward of your visit. We shall be obliged if you make it convenient to visit our showroom at an early date so that you may have the pleasure of making your best choice. Yours faithfully. Stop.